So today we will see, so what are the pest of maize and wheat, how to control them, how they will create the damage on crop, so how to identify them. So first we will see the pest of maize, then we will see the pest of wheat. In pest of maize, so first one is the problematic worm. So before 3 years we don't have this pest in India. So common name is fall armyworm, Spodoptera fusifida, and there belongs to the family Noctidae and order Lepidoptera. So if the family coming Noctidae means there comes under nocturnal feeders, are they active in nights. If any insect very active in night time, especially in moth, they kept under Noctidae. So second one is maize fruit fly, Arthrogonia orientalis, Musidae, Diptera, stem borer, Chylopartilus, Crambidae, Lepidoptera. So while I am pronouncing scientific name, so please listen how I am pronouncing. So what is the fall armyworm? Fall armyworm is Spodoptera fusifida, maize fruit fly, Arthrogonia orientalis, stem borer, Chylopartilus, pink stem borer, Sesamia inferens, cornworm, or we can call earworm also. See common name. So the common name will give the always either structure of the insect or morphology of the insect, or the based upon their damage, creating damage, they have given the names. So see the first fall armyworm. Armyworm means what? Army. So they will move together. They will march in the field. How military army will do? Military army always will move as a groups. So fall army also will do like that. Then maize shoot fly. Shoot fly means what? Shoot. Every plant having a shoot. So it will eat on a shoot. So maize shoot fly. Stem borer. It will bore into the stem. So stem borer, Chylopartilus. Pink stem borer. That means they are pink in color. The larvae is pink in color and they will bore into the stem. So pink stem borer. So cornworm, earworm. Samir, mute your mic. Hey Samir. So cornworm, earworm, Helicobacter pernicera, webworm. So cornworm means they feed on the corns, cob of the maize. So Helicobacter pernicera, fifth one. So Helicobacter pernicera is a commonly we used to call them as a borers, fruit borers. So they are very common in all kind of crops. Tomato, maize, fruits, so a lot of flowers. So Helicobacter pernicera. So sixth one is webworm, Cryptobulbus nidiella. So this is also we have seen before, Answorgum. It will form a webs on the crop. Belongs to family Pyrrhastidae, Lepidoptera. Epid, Rufolus of Maedus. Already we have seen it. Swargam, shoot bug, Peregrinus maedus. So these are all the pests in, major pests in maize. So next we will see one by one how they are creating damage, how to control them. So first one is we will see fall armyworm. Scientific name is Spodoptera fusiferida. So how they will create damage? How we are going to identify them in field level? So I think in Shirpur region in Maharashtra, now the people are planted already maize, so they are in trouble now. Many students are given a lot of post to me personally. They approached me, more than 20 students. Sir, in maize, this is the pest. How to identify them? How to control them like that? So now I will exclusively I will cover on the maize pest. So kindly observe. I will show the difference between the insects, how to identify them based upon the eggs, based upon the larvae type, based upon the adults, and how to control them, how to trap them. So we will learn today. First we will see the fall armyworm, Spodoptera fusiferida. See, fusiferida, they belongs to the family Noctuidae, another Lepidoptera. So they are native to the tropical and subtropical regions of America. They are not native of India. They were introduced to invasive pest in 2018 into the India. It has invaded many African and Asian countries and caused huge economic losses. How they are introduced? Who introduced that one? How they came from Africa to India? Through exports and imports. So we are imported maize from the Africa. So on the maize grains, there is eggs. So there is no proper sanitization. There is no proper treatment, storage precautions. And our plant production officers at border levels, so they have given permission to that commodity. So when the same seed farmers, when we are using in field level, so it emerged in India. So Africa and India, so both are having a almost equal of environmental conditions. So they started growing enormously in India. See the larvae, how they are looking. Fall army larvae. Though fall army worm has infested crops in over 50 countries, not only India, see 50 countries across two continents in just over 2 years. In just 2 years, it was spread in 50 countries in two continents, Asia and Africa. So incidence of fall army worm reported in India during May 2018. So this FAW means fall army worm. And the phylogenetic analysis has revealed that Indian maize fall army worm clustered with Florida rice strain, Ghana, Nigeria, Uganda on maize. So what are all the strains we are seeing in Nigeria, Uganda, Ghana or Florida? Same type of strain also now we are seeing in India. That means this might be traveled any one of these countries. So how to detection of fall armyworm? How to identify is this fall armyworm or other type of pest from the maize? How to detect that? See, I have given larvae and the clear cut labels also I have given here. First, this is the head, sir. This is the head. So where I am roaming, my mark is head, arrow mark, and the opposite one is end of the larvae. If you see the first identification character on head, so can you see this mark here? So this is inverted Y in shape. This is inverted Y in shape. In adults, this is nothing but a frontovertex. So this inverted Y shape is clearly visible on the this larvae, this one. then if you go to the end of the larvae, this is the head of the larvae, this is the end of the larvae, on abdomen you can see four spots here, 1, 2, 3, 4. These four spots, they are arranged in triangular portion, rectangular. See, exactly rectangular. Four spots are arranged in rectangular on the abdomen region. If you see, if you another spots on the body, see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, they are not rectangular in portion. So they are like this somewhere. See, it is going on like this trapeze. This arrangement nothing but a trapeze. So four smaller spots in trapeze arrangement on dorsal surface of the other segments. Only at last segment they are in rectangular position. In remaining segments they are trapeze in shape. See here also four spots. After that, if you see the body, in body we have a different kind of lines. See here, on dorsum of the body we have a different of lines. If you see the middle of the body, pale dorsal line. So the top of the body nothing but a dorsum, the down of the body nothing but a ventrum. So in dorsal side of the body there is a middle pale line. Then you see the side also we have a one more line, and this side also we have a one more line. Totally 1, 2, 3 lines on the body. After that you can see the black color marking here, band here and here. A lateral side we have a black color band. And dorsal area, if you see, the lighter in color. So this is the fully matured fall armyworm larvae morphology. Based upon the head region, we have a inverted Y-shaped front vertex, and this triangular shape of spots, and these spots, all these things. Even in this, we have a different kind of colors. Based upon their English stars, the larvae color will be changed. Sometimes brown, yellow, dark brown, green. So this, which one I am showing, this is the fully grown larvae. It will be appear like this. Then we will see how their appearance of eggs. Here I have given three type of eggs. So beneath this I have given the names also. First one is eggs of fall armyworm, Spodoptera fusiferda. Second one is eggs of oriental leaf worm, Spodoptera litura. And third one is eggs of oriental armyworm, Mythemia separata. So before fall armyworm, this Spodoptera litura and Mythemia separata are the major pest on the sorghum. Hence this newly Spodoptera fusiferda is entered into the India. Now we are seeing this is a major pest. Apart from this, these two are also major pest on the sorghum, on the maize. The same how we are feeling, corona is a dangerous virus now in India. Before corona also we have a lot of viruses. People are dying with the diseases: malaria, dengue, cholera, plague, swine flu, bird flu. So these are all the viruses already entered into the India, but the thing is we have a vaccines for them, so we are not treating them as a big diseases. So hence for corona we don't have a vaccine, we are treating this one as a big virus nowadays. Same like this Spodoptera fusiferda not having a well known control measures, that's why on maize it's become a now major pest. But earlier Spodoptera litura, Mythemia separata also created damage equal to the Spodoptera fusiferda. But thing is, we have a management techniques for that. We developed even within 1 or 2 years also sporopter fusion quota fully controlled. We are going to be controlled fully. At present time, this is a major pest. How to differentiate their legs? See here, if you see the first one and second picture, egg, they have an eggs we have, and that was covered by the hairs, moth hairs. But in third picture, we don't have any hairs. So by that we can separate Mythemia separata from the Sporoptera, Fusiforda and Litura. Why they both are having same type means because both are same, belongs to same genus. See, both are Sporoptera here also. Thing is, species is changing. This is Fusiforda, this is Litura. Okay. So in egg stage, we have to identify them. If there is any egg mass with covered with the hairs, so there might be a fall armyworm eggs. We have to recognize like this. Then after hatching, we have to see the larvae. See here, I am showing the three different type of larvae which will create enormous damage in maize. How they are differentiate? How we are going to be differentiate them? How we are going to be identify them? See the fall armyworm Sporoptera fusiforda first one. How it is looking? Pale in color. But Sporoptera litura is very dark brown. This is also having a three lines on the body. But larvae is too dark and they are yellow in color, and we are clearly seeing these lines. But in this case of fall armyworm, the body are lighter in color and lines also lighter in color. But in oriental armyworm, Mythemia separata, green in color, this is totally different from the Sporoptera larvae. Then fall armyworm adult identification. How to identify them as if they become adult, how to identify them? See here, I have given three images again. The first one is fall armyworm, second one is leaf worm, and third oriental leaf worm, third one is oriental armyworm. This Sporoptera fusiforda morphology, how their wings are appearing, Sporoptera litura, Mythemia separata. See the Sporoptera fusiforda, their big mouth compared with the Sporoptera litura. See their dark, Sporoptera fall armyworm having a dark color wings, but Sporoptera litura having a dark color wings, but on that we have a zigzag manner of many lines. See the lines here, zigzag manner. Here we don't have a lines on the body in the case of Mythemia separata. See the difference between three adults in maize. Then life cycle of the Sporoptera fusiforda. See the slide first. See the egg, 100 to 200 eggs. They are laying as a batches and they are covered with the lot of scales. And the second image showing that hatching larvae. This is eggs. If larvae will be hatched, they look like this. See the larval instars. Well, that larva is looking. Then see the pupae. Then another stage. See, once this life cycle, read the labels. Have you seen this life cycle? Then we will see one by one how, where they will lay the eggs, how to manage and all these things. First, if you see the eggs, here I am showing the maize plant. And that I am showing the eggs also. So they used to lay the eggs on the leaf or below the leaf, or inside the whole. The whole means the whole position, nothing but a where the new leaves are coming. So when there is a 2-3 leaves are coming, so there is a some small holes will be available on the top of the maize plants, or you can see in sorghum or in sugar cane. So this is nothing but a holes. Then lay the egg masses. Each egg masses will contain nearly 1000 eggs. So each and moss, they will lay the eggs clusters on the maize plants. See the whole region, the first sinister caterpillars. So this is the holes, WHORLS, holes. This is the whole region. The first sinister larvae will be eat on the regularly at side of the leaves. They cannot bore into the middle of the leaf, but they will eat on the side of the leaves where newly growing active leaves are there. See, first sinister larvae damage symptoms in maize students. If you are, I think everybody having a maize fields in your surrounding villages or surrounding cities also. If you are living in cities, just travel 10 kilometers out from the city, you can find a lot of maize crops. Please kindly visit this Sunday and see all these kind of symptoms. So you can, if you once crop will grow, then you cannot find all these things. So this is a subject we have to learn as an agriculture student from entomology part. So the damage, crop damage, how they are doing, based upon the damage, how we have to identify the pest, how to give the recommendations. If you are unable to learn these things also, there is no meaning in doing agriculture BSc. Nobody will give job. So nobody will ask you in an entrance exam, in practical or while they are taking as a employee, nobody will ask you, tell me the coleoptera order, what are all the scientific names of coleoptera and beetles. They will not ask all these things. So they are basics. Scientific study, that is. Scientific identification. So this is the farm level identification, practical experience. Practically, our duty is to identify the damage symptom, or based upon the pest, how to give the recommendation to the crop. So whatever we have seen first semester is the basics. We are understanding their physiology, morphology. What is antennae? What is head? What is wing? What is leg? How their digestion will be work? What is it? How that we are differing from beetles and lepidopteran digestive system? How we are going to be? Then only we have to understand which kind of recommendation we have to give. The second semester we have seen economic entomology. In that we have discussed what are the economic insects, parasites, predators. So they are beneficial insects. Now we are seeing the crop pest. So these are the harmful insects. How to identify them? How they will create the damage on the crops? How to manage them? Don't miss entomology classes, guys. It is very important class. For entomology degree, for basic agriculture means, so the entomology, out of this entomology, this semester is very important. Unfortunately, you guys are unable to sit in my class before me. Otherwise, I would have trained you a lot, very nicely. You are sitting somewhere, I am sitting somewhere. I am trying to explain to you. I don't know how many guys are you listening properly. Here, nothing is there. Just we are seeing the symptoms based upon that we are discussing how they are creating the damage. So first sinister caterpillar will eat like this. Segregated larvae feed superficially on the side of the larvae, side of the leaf, or inside the walls, and spread to new host plant through the ballooning mechanism. See here the word. So they'll feed on the side of the leaf, all inside the wall. Okay, that is fine. So and spread to new host plant through ballooning mechanism. What is this mechanism? So adult nothing but a mother insect is laying eggs, 1000 eggs in a single plant. Out of that, imagine 500 larvae will be emerge from the 1000 eggs, out of 1000 eggs. So they are starting eating on the plant. The 500 larvae are eating on single plant means there are a lot of competition. They want to migrate to the other other crop. What they have to do? They have to change their plant. They are very small larvae. How they will change one plant to another plant? Here it is using the ballooning mechanism. What is this ballooning mechanism? For example, last semester we have studied that the Lepidopteran larvae will produce the silk. How spiders are webbing silk. So that like the larvae also will produce the silk. With that silk, what that will do? It will attach one end to the leaf and it will catch another end and it will hang to the ground. It will land on the ground and it will slowly walk. It will reach the another plant. So this hanging mechanism with the help of their saliva, nothing but a silk, is called ballooning mechanism in Lepidoptera. Is it clear? Then next one is initial sign of infestation. How the initially it will appear? So papery minnows on leaf and defoliation. You can see here, you can see my cursor mark. Initially it will be scrap the chlorophyll alone from the leaf because they have a very small mandibles. They can scrap the chlorophyll from the leaf. Once the instar will be changed, second instar, third instar, then they will start on the whole leaf because the mandible will get fit and strong. So when initial larvae is, see the another diagrams near the below of this. These are all how the leaves are looking like. This chlorophyll is scratched and like it is looking like some disease, but it is caused by the first instar larvae of Sporotrophysifera. This is the initial symptoms. Then see the second instar larvae. Caterpillars of all larvae feed gregariously in initial phase and make small leaf holes or papery windows. See here, my cursor mark. Here. See, it is feeding on this. It is feeding on chlorophyll. Then third instar larvae, see sir, third instar larvae, the first image and second image. See the second image, it is almost started eating on the whole nothing but actively growing leaves and plant stem. These are leaves. So often feed solitarily inside the holes and causes large holes accompanied by the larval droppings, excreta. See the droppings in first image. How their excreta is looking. If you are unable to see the damage after seeing excreta, you can find out there is an insect. We have to take the control measures. See how they are feeding in second image. Then some we can see the larval coloration. In different instars, they have a different kind of flower coloration. This is because of the defense mechanism. See early instars, middle instars, late instars. The type of infestation, how fecal matter is there. Once they started feeding, they'll feed on all active growing leaves and stem. They cannot get even the flower. So caterpillars show different colorations and hide inside the holes during daytime. Sawdust like appearance of dry excrement often seen on leaves, which protect them from natural enemies by camouflage. So these colorations, the designs, lines, everything is a camouflage or defense mechanism. So they have to protect them from the other enemies. Whatever the morphologies, structures they are showing, only for fighting, for want of fighting, not for anything. Then see the cannibalism and fall armyworm. So this is very important, sir, for your examination purpose and competitive examination purpose. Cannibalism. See the word cannibalism means what? Cannibalism nothing but a the same species of individual will feed on the other individual. If human being feed other human being means that is cannibalism. Human being will eat on other human being. Luckily, that is not happening in a human case. Very rarely will happen. Psychos. But in the case of this, not only fall armyworm, in the case of Spodoptera, Spodoptera itself having a cannibalism mechanism. Here, big mature larvae will eat on immature larvae. This is a very peculiar character of this Spodoptera genus. That's why while rearing these insects also, we cannot rear them as other insects. We have to rear them in a cavity blocks. The tray having a different type of cavities. Like in refrigerator, we are keeping water now to make ice, deep freezes. Like that, cavity trays will be available. In each tray, we have to keep one larvae and we have to feed them. If you keep all the larvae together, it will eat on one on other and you will lose your culture. Very peculiar character this is. Cannibalism in Spodoptera. So this is comparative examination question. Then mature caterpillars and pupa of fall armyworm. How the mature caterpillars and pupa will be look like? So you often hide inside the walls and drop down to the make cotton cocoons inside the soil. So they will be cocoonized inside the soil. After feeding on the walls, after mature, they'll come to the soil. They'll become a pupa. So because of that only, based upon the instars, based upon the life cycle, we have to select the insecticide. If you know that fall armyworm, they can do the pupation inside the soil. So at the late age, we have to go for the soil application of insecticides. If you can able to identify their eggs, oh, egg moss is there. It may be a Spodoptera egg moss. Immediately, if you take the action, our crop under safe condition. Or immediately after seeing first instar larvae or damage of first instar larvae, if you identify them the damage, if you take action, again we are under safe condition. So insecticide, who are all selling insecticide vendors don't know all these things. They're businessmen. They don't know what is the morphology, they don't know what is the biology of insect, they don't know how they are creating damage. A farmer will go take one piece of sample and he will take to the vendor. Farmer also don't know that this vendor don't know anything. How the farmer will don't know all these things? The vendor will give one insecticide, so which he can get a lot of margin. He don't know he's a poison prolitura or Spodoptera marusia or Spodoptera pugnifera. He don't know anything. And he don't know which stage of insect is causing this damage also. He will give simply one insecticide. Farmer will believe that he'll pay money and he'll take and he'll spend a lot of time, lot of labor wages, a lot of money, and he'll take the spray even though it will not control. So as agriculture graduates, you need not to do the job. You can do your own business also. If you learn all these things, then you have some idea. So if you are giving the good recommendation, good time to the farmers, your business also will increase and as well as farmers also in the safe side. Then we have seen so far how they are looking, how they are creating damage, eggs, pupae, larvae, everything we have seen. Now we will see the management, how to control the Spodoptera pugnifera. So this is not having a single type of management. We have a In each and every pest, we have a multiple types of management techniques. So after trying all these things, at last only we have to choose the chemical control. But people used to directly spray the insecticide. They will not do anything. If there is a pest, we have to purchase the insecticide with a lot of cost and we have to spray. See, then the insecticide, we have a lot of techniques. Just see all these things, now I'll explain. So before chemical management, we have to go for the integrated pest management strategies. They are very cost effective. safe to the environment, safe to your crop, crop and your health also. The first one is our duty. First we have to do the monitoring. Without monitoring, you simply sowing the crop, and if you are sleeping inside the home, if you are visiting crop once in a month, no use. Every 3 days once we have to visit, take a visit to the crop. The visit means not from the road. If you want to monitor your crop, you have to leave your chappals, shoe, socks, pant, everything outside. You have to enter into the field. You have to sit into the field. You have to close them monitorly. You have to spend minimum 1 hour. Then only you can able to understand the what happening inside the crop. If you are standing on road and if you see, means everything will be appearing as a green and healthy only. And while sowing field, don't use any shoe, any jean pant on all these things. That will not allow you inside the field. You will feel, array, my shoe will be spoiled. My pant, I am unable to afford the pant. While entering into the field, our dress code also will be suitable for the exam in the, that means roaming into the fields. First we have to do the monitoring. First go to the field and see slowly, plant by plant, at least choose 10 plants randomly and see top to bottom whether there is any damage, there is any fecal matter, any defoliation, any spots. So randomly in 10 places, 10 plants we have to see like that. Then scouting. For monitoring, while doing monitoring, we have to scout. How to walk into the field. We should not scout on single side or in a single line. So that how to do that scouting we will learn. We are going to be learning this class. Then cultural control. What are the cultural controls? Mechanical controls, biological control methods. Stage wise options including chemical control. So this is the procedure. First we will see one by one. First, monitoring. How to monitor the pest? So we have a two type of monitorings. One is in situ counts, in situ monitoring, and otherwise another one is with the help of traps. In situ means you are entering into the field, you are seeing with the naked eyes, and we are assuming that what are all the pests or insects are available on your crop. Another method is trapping method. For example, nocturnal insects, they are active in nocturnal daytime, so they will not come out. How we will see? Very difficult. So if you keep the traps, light traps or pheromone traps, they will trap to the particular trap, and morning we will go and observe in the traps what kind of insects are there. So for monitoring purpose, what we have to do? Installation of pheromone traps 5 per acre in the current and potential area of spread in crop season of off season. We have to keep 5 pheromone traps for monitoring of the, if you want to monitor which kind of pest, we have to monitor that pest. Or if you know well known, that means as a agriculture graduate, you know all the insects. So you go for the light trap. Light will be attract lot of insects. In that you can choose whatever you want. Or if you don't know about the entomology, how you will identify the insects? Go to the shop vendor, or go to any scientist, or go to any university, or go to any agriculture graduate. Ask them, I want to know whether Sporoptera fusiferata are available in my field or not. They will suggest you lure, pheromone lure. Buy them 30 rupees from the market. And keep in your field. Here I am showing the position of the pheromone trap. So this is the, here we are using the pheromone lure. Then they will attract in this way and they will follow into the cover. So what are all the fusiferata available in our crop? They will attract to this lure and they will follow in cover. Go and see in morning. If there is no insects, then you need not to worry. There is no fusiferata in our field. If there is any insects, they are fusiferata only, because you are keeping sex pheromone. So understand how to monitor them. Like this Sporoptera litera having their own pheromone lures. Like that Hippocampa armigera having pheromone lures. Like that Caelopatilus having a pheromone lure. Then scouting. instead of counting, when you are as a farmer, you are looking into the field. See here, how the image is showing here, right side. So W in shape. See the shape of the image. We have to scout like this. We should not walk in one row or one side or the borders. In W format, we have to walk into the crop. We have to start here and select one plant here and see. Then come like this, then go like this, then come like this, then go like this in W manner. So by that time, we can cover the entire field in all the sides. Start scouting in W manner as soon as maize seedlings emerge. At seedling to early wall stage, that means early stages, at seedling to early wall stage, 3 to 4 weeks after emergence. Once you sown the crop, after beginning the emergence, then 3 to 4 weeks, nearly a month. At seedling to early wall stage means nearly first month of the after planting. Action can be taken if 5% plants are damaged. So you have sown the crop. Within a 1 month, if you want to take any control measures, walk in W manner, then see, count it. How many plants you are visiting, out of that how many plants are damaged. So damaged plants divided by total number of plants you have visited into 100 is, it will give the percentage. So if it is a more than 5%, then you have to take the immediately control measures. At mid-wall to late-wall stage, that means after 5 to 7 weeks after emergence, nearly 2 months. So at mid-wall to later-wall stage, action can be taken if 10% walls are freshly damaged. We cannot count the older damaged plants, the freshly damaged we have to see. If it is 10% in mid-wall stage and 20% damage in late-wall stage, then at tasseling and post-tasseling, so when the flower is coming, the silking stage, when the calves are producing silk, so do not spray insecticides, it will not work out. In that stage, all the insects are inside the cob or inside the plant. They will not feed on the leaf at all. If you spray the insecticide, it will not give the cost effective. But we can remove the what are all appearing larvae from the cobs. They are very big. So engage the labor, let them hand pick of the larvae or use the lures. So like that, we have to take the action. So early stages, how much of percent if infestation is there, we have to take the control measures. At late stage and after maturing stage, like that we have to. Then cultural measures. So deep plowing is recommended before sowing. So after sowing crop, when they are damaging, instead of running here and there, begging here and there, sir, my crop is damaging, save my crop, instead of begging the insecticide shop owners, instead of spending money on them, so do some minimum practices in our field before sowing. Everybody knows this, including farmers, everybody knows this, but few people will do the common practices, but few people will not bother about all these things. So first we have to do the cultural methods. Deep plowing is recommended before sowing. We have to go for the deep plowing. This will expose FAM, fall armyworm pupae, to predators. The pupae happening in the soil, if you once destroy the pupae, adult will not come out. They will not lay the eggs. They will not hatch as a larvae. And timely sowing is advised. If the university is recommending particular time, so they will recommend. So the maize in June, last week to July 1st week. We have to sow in that time. We should not delay the crop. Then avoid staggered sowing. Avoid staggered sowing, bulk sowing and all these things. The intercropping of maize with suitable pulse crops of particular region. So maize plus PGNP or black gram or green gram. So always in maize we can sow the PGNP or black gram, green gram as a intercrops. So what they will do, they will attract the pest. They will divert the pest from the maize to on the PGNP or black gram or green gram. PGNP nothing but a red gram, all the grams. Then erection of bird perches. Last class I have shown what is a bird perches. So T-shaped sticks. Azurate 10 per acre during early stage of the crop up to 30 days. Then sowing of 3 to 4 rows of trap crops. Example, Nipier in maize. Around maize field and spray with 5% NSKE or Azadirachtin 1500 ppm as soon as the trap crop shows symptom of fall or mealworm damage. The clean cultivation and balanced use of fertilizers. We should not spray them, or we should not just apply them heavy doses of urea fertilizers. The cultivation of maize hybrids with tight husk cover with reduced ear damage by the fall armyworm. We have to choose the varieties that can husk will be tightly form on the cob. So these are all the cultural measures. So with this we will stop today. So remaining three we will see the next class. Okay guys, now this is for discussion. If anybody having any doubts, you can ask.
No sir.
No sir.
Sagar? Sagar Patel?
Yes sir.
So try to observe the type of infestation in our maize surrounding fields.
Yes sir.
So yesterday what you have shown, that cotton crop damage, the leaf damage, it is not a major pest. It might be a damage from grasshoppers and all these things.
Yes sir.
If it is a heavy damage in crop, just to go for the NSKE spraying, neem seed kernel extract or neem oil extract.
Yes sir.
Otherwise you need not to bother about that pest.
Okay sir.
If any pest is feeding on your flower and the bowls of the or shoots of the plant, then take a picture and send me. We will recommend that. On leaves, no need to take any recommendation.
Okay sir.
Yeah, everything is are you listening? Are you able to audible? Is there no disturbance? No, everything is clear while I am speaking.
Yes sir. Yes sir. Yes sir.
Right. If anybody having any doubts, you can contact us.
Yes sir.
Thank you. Right. We will meet in practical.
Okay sir.